Okay, so let's talk about another example of the substitution method. So here we need to look at both of our equations, and we need to pick one of these equations to substitute into the other one. So again, remember when it comes to picking which equation we're going to plug in, what you need to do is you need to take a look at which one of these equations possibly has a 1 as a coefficient. The whole point of substitution method is to take one of these equations and plug it into the other one. And the easiest way to do that is to find one of your coefficients that has a 1 as a coefficient there. So, like, we're either looking at x or looking at y at either equation. Doesn't matter which one. So if I look at the bottom equation, I have a negative 10 in front of the y. That's not a 1. I have a 2 in front of this x. Not going to help me. I have a 5 here, right? But over here, I do have a negative 1 here, and I can work with that. Not that you can't use one of the other ones over here. It just means it's going to be uglier to solve. We're more than likely going to have to deal with fractions and things of that nature, which is why we always try and find the one that has a 1 for a coefficient. Makes our life easier. So, for this particular example, I'm going to be taking my top equation, and specifically, I'm going to be solving it for x. So I'm just going to pull this equation out over here, and what I want to do is I want to get this solved for x, so get the x completely by itself. So by doing that, so let's see, I need to add 4 to both sides first. Negative 4 plus 4 cancels, and I get 5y plus 4 is equal to negative x. Just need to get rid of that negative right there in front of the x. So remember, that's like saying negative 1 times x. So we do the opposite by dividing out that negative 1, leaving us with a negative 5y minus 4 is equal to x. Now, here we need to pause a little bit and realize what we have here. So we have one of our equations solved for x. So x is equal to negative 5y minus 4. So if x is equal to this, this means these are interchangeable. X is this, this is x. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go back up here, and I'm going to take a look at the equation that I have not used yet. So I didn't touch this bottom equation. And what I'm going to do now is, if x equals negative 5y minus 4, that means I should be able to take the negative 5y minus 4 and plug that in for x, because x equals this. So I should be able to plug this into this equation here. So we're substituting this equation into this one. That's what the whole substitution method is about. Substitute one of your equations into the other one. Just, it's always easier, it makes our life easier if we're able to pick one of our variables that has a 1 in front. So always go with that one, solve for that variable there, and plug into the other one. So I'm going to plug in negative 5y minus 4 in for x here. So that means I'll have a negative 10y is equal to 2. Negative, hold on, let me scooch this down a little bit. Negative 10y is equal to 2, and instead of x, I'm putting negative 5y minus 4, and then plus 8. So this exact equation here, only difference is I'm plugging in the negative 5y minus 4 for the x. Everything else stays the same. So we need to solve this equation here. So if we need to solve this equation, we're distributing that 2. So drop down the negative 10y is equal to negative 10y, negative 8 there when we multiply, plus 8. All right, so let's see, let's do some simplifying. Negative 8 plus 8, well, negative 8 plus 8 is 0, that goes away, leaving me with negative 10y is equal to negative 10y. Okay, well, the only thing I can really do here is maybe get rid of the negative 10 and say, hey, I'm going to divide both sides by negative 10. And when I do that, well, negative 10 cancels with negative 10, leaving me with y is equal to, well, that also cancels out over there. Negative 10 over negative 10, and I'm left with y is equal to y. When you have a situation like this, So typically when you're solving systems, regardless what method it is, if you're left with kind of a weird answer there that kind of makes you think, hold up, what did I do? Did I do something wrong? Sometimes, well, possibly sometimes you did do something wrong, but for the most part, it's because you have one of your special cases. So when it comes to solving systems, you can either have one solution, one point as your answer, you can have no solution, or infinitely many solutions. So this is one of the special cases, no solution or infinitely many solutions. But take a look at your answer. Does y equal y? Now, y does equal y. It may look a little bit funny, right? But y is equal to y. That is true. It makes sense. So when you're left with something like this, this is actually called infinitely many solutions, which means it does not matter what you plug in for X, what you plug in for Y, everything is going to work because these are the exact same line, which means every single point is gonna fall on every single point, matches up perfectly, you have infinitely many solutions. So the varying answers could look like Y equals Y, X equals X, 10 equals 10, or something like that. But X does equal X, 10 equals 10, Y equals Y. This is what an infinitely many solutions looks like.